Have you ever been tracking a flight online or looking at a route map and noticed that the path between two cities, like New York and Tokyo, isn't a straight line? Instead, it curves, sometimes dramatically, over the Arctic or the North Pacific. At first glance, it seems strange. Shouldn't the shortest distance between two points be a straight line? So why do airplanes seem to take these huge detours? The answer isn't that planes are dodging invisible walls in the sky or flying around the world just for fun. The real reason has everything to do with the shape of our planet, how we represent it on maps, and how physics, geography, and navigation all play a role in designing efficient, safe, and cost-effective flight paths. Let's start with the most basic idea. We live on a sphere, or more precisely, an oblate spheroid. But in most cases, we treat it as a sphere when it comes to navigation. On a sphere, the shortest distance between two points is not a straight line like on paper. It's something called a great circle. A great circle is any circle drawn on a sphere that divides it into two equal halves. Think of the equator or the lines of longitude. If you stretch a string tightly between two cities on a globe, say Los Angeles and London, it arcs upward because that's the shortest path along the surface. But when we flatten the Earth into a map, especially the popular Mercator projection, things start to look misleading. On a Mercator map, which preserves angles and straight lines for navigation, areas near the poles are heavily distorted. Greenland looks the size of Africa when it's nowhere near that big. That's why a great circle route looks curved on your flight tracker or map app. The plane is flying a straight path over the globe, but the map makes it look like a bend. So now that we understand why flight paths look curved on flat maps, let's talk about why airlines and pilots choose these routes. It comes down to efficiency, saving time, saving fuel, and reducing costs. Airplanes burn a tremendous amount of fuel. Every minute in the air has a cost, and over thousands of flights per day, that cost adds up to millions. The Great Circle route minimizes the distance traveled, and even shaving off a few hundred kilometers can mean thousands of dollars saved in fuel. For long-haul international flights, especially those that cross oceans or continents, the difference between a straight-line rum route and a curved Great Circle route can be significant. For example, flying from San Francisco to Tokyo on a Great Circle route takes the aircraft near Alaska and the Aleutian Islands, which seems like a detour, but it's actually the shortest path over Earth's surface. But distance isn't the only factor. Weather is a major one. Pilots and dispatchers examine wind patterns, jet streams, storms, and turbulence forecasts to optimize the route. Catching a strong tailwind can drastically reduce flight time. On the other hand, airspace restrictions like military zones, political no-fly areas, or dangerous regions can require planes to take alternative paths. So even if the Great Circle path would go through one of those zones, pilots must detour for safety and compliance. And then there's traffic. Yes, the sky has traffic too. Air traffic control sectors can get congested, especially over busy regions like Europe, the North Atlantic, or the eastern U.S. coast. Flights are often routed along airways, predefined corridors in the sky, to maintain separation and keep the system safe and organized. That's another reason why two flights between the same cities might take slightly different paths on different days. Let's come back to the idea of rum lines for a moment. A rum line is a path of constant bearing. That means the direction relative to north doesn't change. On a Mercator map, it looks like a straight line. These routes were historically easier to navigate using simple compasses and charts. But over long distances, a rum line is longer than a great circle route. So while it's easier to draw and understand, it's less efficient. That's why modern aircraft navigation systems favor great circles unless restricted. Now, here's another fascinating aspect. When an aircraft follows a great circle route, it doesn't actually fly in a constant direction. The heading, the direction the nose of the airplane points, must change gradually throughout the flight. That's because as you move along Earth's curved surface, your compass reference changes. But don't worry, pilots aren't adjusting the heading every few minutes manually. Modern commercial jets are equipped with highly advanced navigation systems that compute great circle routes, adjust for wind and weather, and continuously update the aircraft's heading and altitude. Pilots input the route into the flight management computer before departure, and the autopilot system takes care of the rest, keeping the plane aligned with the intended path, even as that path subtly curves across the globe. Let's consider a real-world example, flying from London to Los Angeles. If you look at a flat map, it might seem logical to fly westward in a straight horizontal line, But the shortest route actually curves northwest, passing near Iceland and Greenland, then down through Canada before reaching Los Angeles. That arc looks like a big deviation, but it's actually hundreds of kilometers shorter than flying what looks like a straight line. And this isn't just about saving fuel. Time is money in aviation. Shorter routes mean faster turnaround times for aircraft, better scheduling for crews, and less wear on the engines. Over the course of a year, even small efficiencies add up. Airlines compete on punctuality, reliability, and cost, so every nautical mile saved matters. There's also a practical consideration when flying over polar regions. Some great circle routes pass close to or over the poles. These are called polar routes, and they're used for flights like New York to Hong Kong or Chicago to Beijing. These routes weren't always possible due to magnetic compass errors and limited communications, but with modern satellite navigation and long-range communication systems, polar routes are now both common and highly efficient. You might also notice that flights between two cities don't always take the same path in both directions. That's because of wind, especially high-altitude jet streams. On transatlantic flights, pilots try to ride the jet stream when flying east and avoid it when flying west. That's why a westbound leg might take over 7 hours, while the return flight could be just over 6. So, to bring it all together, 1. Straight lines on flat maps can be misleading. 2. The shortest distance on a globe is called a great circle. 3. That path looks curved when projected onto a flat map. 4. Airlines follow these routes to save time, fuel, and money. 5. Modern navigation systems automatically adjust course throughout the flight. When you see a plane arc northward on a map, it's not going the long way. It's actually going the most efficient way Earth allows. So now, every time you see a plane veer off what looks like a straight path, you'll know. It's not wrong, it's science in action. The curve you see on the flight map isn't some strange error or detour. It's the product of physics, geography, mathematics, and decades of engineering refinement all working together. Aviation is an art form hidden inside hard science. Great circle routes save fuel, cut flight time, reduce emissions, and ultimately make aviation more efficient and sustainable. From the outside, it may seem simple. A plane goes from point A to point B, but under the surface, millions of calculations are taking place every second to make sure it's done with precision. What's fascinating is how something that seems unintuitive at first, that curved is shorter than straight, becomes so obvious once you understand how our planet is shaped and how navigation systems interpret it. In many ways, aviation forces us to see the world differently, not just literally, but mentally too. It teaches us that the shortest path in life may not always look straight, and sometimes the smartest route is the one that curves. If you're someone who's curious about how the skies work, or maybe you're training to be a pilot, or simply a lover of flight and exploration, this channel is made for you. We break down complex aviation topics and reveal the hidden logic behind every takeoff, landing, and route in the sky. So if you learned something new today, or even if you just gained a new perspective on something you thought you understood, hit that like button. Subscribe for weekly deep dives into the world of aviation, and don't be shy. Drop a comment telling us what aviation mystery you'd like to see decoded next, because up here in the sky, nothing is random. Every curve has a reason. And now, you know why. Enjoyed the journey? Like this video to help more curious minds discover the science behind the skies. Subscribe and turn on notifications for weekly aviation deep dives. Got a question about flying or air routes? Drop it in the comments. We might cover it next.